Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for joining me again today on another Texan Camper episode of Tim Was Here. Today I'm exploring a new camping area. It's kind of a drive-in campsite, kind of like Hunter's Camp, or where I videoed Kelly's Pond. This one doesn't have a specific name that I can look up. It's just off of Forest Service Road 220, which is basically 59 North. Take exit FM 2025. Take that northeast until you come to FS220, which is where I'm at right now. It's just an unpaved dirt road. And you know you're on the right track because you'll see this sign here. Let me turn the camera on and I'll show you. You got a sign sitting right there. Protect and enjoy your national forest. And I guess this is the camping area. So I'm going to go down this road and do a little bit of a recon, kind of get you guys a feel for this area. This is a drive-in camping area. No fees or anything. It's kind of in the same general area as the Double Lake recreational area, just to give you kind of a pinpoint idea. Of course, I'll leave GPS, all the coordinates down below in the description box so you guys can find this area, but let's go down this road, see what we can find. Alright, so you can see the road is unpaved, it's a dirt road, it's not too pitted, and they say the speed limit's about 30 miles an hour, but I'm just cruising around 10, but you can see it's very thick, so we're in the month of April, here on the 9th or the 10th, I forgot the date today, but I'm just trying to see where you can kind of pull your car into, and looks like this might be a spot you can park your car and maybe camp down there. Just keep on going. I don't know if, yeah, I guess you can back your car up and just walk down there. But that's one little area there. Maybe you can pull in your car. I don't see why not. You can see the vegetation is very thick. Beautiful greenery. All the green leaves are coming in. You know, it's springtime, so a lot of pines. This is in East Texas, so these are a lot of pine trees in this area. I'm not sure how far down this road goes, maybe about a mile, but if I see anything interesting when I approach it, we'll come back to you. Alright, I've approached kind of an opening here. There's somebody back there, so I don't want to record to that person, but I'm going to try and get as close as I can. This looks like a pretty open area. There's a big hole there. I'm not going to drive into that hole, but I'm just going to kind of smooth in right around here and give you kind of a 360 of the area. This is pretty open to bring your... Joey, you're going to love this. This is kind of an off-road thing here. But I don't want to go too far because it is very pitted. Let me get out of the car, maybe park it here for a second, get out and kind of do some exploring. So, Joey, see all that right there, little mounds there? You'd freaking love this. You can just do your little off-roading gig here. Check this out. You can't see it on the camera, but it's all dipped in right there. Your pumpkin would probably bottom out right there. This is so cool. You would love it out here. Anyways, it goes all the way back in there. This is just a little service road that kind of goes off there. I'm about half a mile in on that road, and this is the first spot I came up to. Plenty of tree separation. This has got good potential. But there's a guy back there, and I'm not going to walk back there and start recording with him there. Then there's a little, kind of a little road where you can go in your car and park there. Yeah, it's very wide open. Here's where I entered right here. Very, very nice. All right, folks, let's keep on exploring. Let me do a quick wide scan here of the area. It's pretty open back up in here. Seems to be plenty of wood around here if you want to make a campfire or whatnot. Lots of pines, all the little saplings coming in. Very, very nice. Alright, there's no exit. There's only one point in. I thought this went out, but it doesn't exit, so. Alright, pretty nice. So I started coming down this road, and I noticed there was a lot of smoke, and I thought at first it was a campfire, but the ground is completely scorched. I don't know if this is a prescribed burn, but I think I'm in the middle of an actual forest fire. I didn't see anything coming in. There seems to be a road down there. I don't know what's down that road, but yeah, you can smell it in the air. It smells like burnt rubber with wood. Or the smell of just live trees burning, which is kind of gross. But yeah, this whole ground is warm. I don't know if it's warm or not. Let me come up on here and see. Yeah, you can feel the heat. This must be a prescribed burn or something. Oh yeah, that's still hot. Yeah, this is fresh. This must have been a pretty big fire. Look at that. This is still smoking out here. This log right here is still smoking. I don't know if this is a natural thing or if they just come out here and prescribe burn it. I don't know what's going on here. I figured if they had it prescribed burn, they'd have this road closed off. But yeah, there's smoke everywhere. This is a fresh fire. Anyways, I'm digressing. Let's get back to the trail. Well, I can't seem to get down this road. I'm in my Ultima, but Joey, your 4x4 would have no problem going down and exploring this road. It'd give you little bumps and bump you up and down the road, but it's pretty cool. I got to actually reverse out of here so I can get out of here. I should not have gone down this little road. I didn't go more than 100 feet, but it goes down there pretty far. Good little off-road experience. That's if the gate's open when we get to this area. All right, back to the trails. Okay, so I just left that area that I was just trying to drive down that road. Went about another 200 yards, give or take. Came across this area here. You'll identify it with this water well here. Yeah, this is definitely a prescribed burn. It looks like they're just trying to clear out the undergrowth. Probably what they're doing. I don't know. But yeah, you can see. You probably can't see it very well in the camera, but it's pretty. But this is a campsite here. Anyways, I'm digressing. This is a campsite. See, I pulled in over there. Actually, I think this is a pipeline, not really water. I think this is oil. I don't know. Anyways, yeah, you can see right along the tree line is where it's all burnt. And looks like some folks were probably already out here, but yeah, it's all black. Look at this. This is all burned. This is a prescribed burn. They just put accelerant down, burned it all out. And so, yeah. You can camp underneath this tree right here. Maybe set up some hammocks. Looks like somebody had a little campfire over here. Plenty of wood around here to burn if need be. It's kind of open here for tents and whatnot, but this is kind of nasty right now. This sucks. I don't be camping out in the ash. Anyway, somebody left some wood here. Had a fire. They left their trash here. Oh, looks like they're making s'mores. What'd they leave here? Look at this. You gotta be kidding me. Anyways, so you can put a tent out here. Man, you can get a big group out here. This is nice. Joey, check this out. Alright guys, let's go see if we can find some more of these spots. Alright, so I just left that last spot you noticed, and park there, and I just walked up this little road here. You can actually drive up here, but it's kind of rough for my car. But Joey, your off-road vehicle, your 4Runner, can come up here very nicely. So you kind of come up this road here, and then it opens up to this. Back over there is where the hiking trail is. You can see the signs posted. Got a little bench there, or a log. But yeah, it looks to be a tent pad, possibly over here. Let me kind of walk over here and show you. Excuse the shakiness, I'm trying to steady it here. But this looks like a, yeah, this is a tent pad. Yeah, somebody had a fire going there. This is a little campsite. This is super cool. Look at this. What's really cool is that there's two of them. With a bag line to hang your food up to keep the squirrels and the pesky critters away. You can see right there. Somebody had their bag up there. They set it on fire, melted it. Anyways, so yeah, this is a tent pad. Put your tent on. Maybe hang some hammocks out here. A couple nice trees to between that tree, you can hang a hammock. But yeah, and there's plenty of other spots in the back area. But yeah, it's pretty wide open. A lot of potential out here. Very nice. There's the little road that I came in on right there. And I'm parked down over there. So this is another little spot. Man, this is nice. So just so you know where I'm at, I'm in the National Forest, Sam Houston National Forest, off of Forest Service Road 220. And so far we found three awesome little car camping spots. You can drive your car up here with your family. Kind of hang out. This is all primitive, 100% primitive. No running water or electricity. If that's your thing, this is where you need to be at. All right, well, this is the end of the journey because the road is closed off. This is about as far as I can go, but we found three potential campsites, Joey. This is very nice out here. Now that everything is burned and all the undergrowth is gone, there's not many potential for snakes out here now, obviously. It's all burnt. So, let's pan back around one more time, just so you can see. Somebody was just recently out here because they left their logs there. This is very nice, very, very nice. All right, folks. So here's some more of this burn going on out here. Big old fire. Ooh, smoky. Let's get out of here. It's kind of nasty. Now, I want to kind of point out one more little spot that could be for camping here. This little hill right here. Anyways, it's just right off the road. I kind of backed in. This is right when you kind of pull into the road at the beginning of the video. But I'm just going to walk back here for a second, just kind of explore. Kind of. This could be just a little walk-in area. Nothing fancy out here. Pretty exposed to the sun. There's not much shade, but somebody's already camped out here. You can see there's a fire right there. That was somebody had a little fire pit, and it kind of goes off in the back there. I don't think there's much else back there, but see what we got over here. It appears to be a grave site for somebody's dogs. Let's take a closer look here. I'm not gonna desecrate their burial ground, but looks like they nailed their gloves in. I guess way of honoring their pets, but looks like the name is Trixie and Tugboat. I guess they left their collars here. This has been here for a while. You can see the rust on the chains. Looks like somebody kind of buried their dogs out here. Yeah. Not sure what else this could be, but a little makeshift gravesite for somebody's pets. Kind of like, I guess, a pet cemetery. Hopefully the Blair Witch doesn't come out, but so it kind of, there's my car back there. I'm just kind of going down. I don't think it goes very far. I don't know. Let's see what else is down here. It's not much. There's some fallen debris, trees. I guess it goes back and further. That's about it. Alright, well, I don't want to go too far back there. Alright folks, that's the end of this journey. Let's head back to the car. Like I said, if you guys want to do some car camping, this is a great little spot off of Forest Service Road 220. And inside the Sam Houston National Forest. If you're out here, be safe, be careful. Pick up your trash. Make sure you put out your campfires. Leave it the way it was when you got here, so that we can always enjoy these areas. This is your host, the Texan Camper, with another episode, wrapping it up, of Tim Was Here. All right, folks, till the next time we meet.